Chag Sameach. As we celebrate this new cycle of the spring festivals, I would like to express my gratitude, my thanks, and even my awe to all of those who have made the connections that communities have been able to build this year possible. As faith leaders, we are often blessed with the privilege of being the face, of being in front of a community, of being that face, that voice that people see and hear. But this year, especially, it has felt that we have had a chance to have a little taste of humility as we watched the community take ownership of itself, to watch our members, our volunteers, our lay leaders own the space that is so rightfully theirs. And we had to learn to take a step back. And so I want to say thank you to all of you who made it possible for us to connect with our communities virtually and at times also in person. Thank you for being so motivated, for being so inspirational and dedicated, and for being so present on Rosh Hashanah when one of the platforms that is often used changed some of its settings. Those volunteers who understood technology were on hand to offer support immediately. All of you who have had experience in supporting ways in which we can connect with each other, support each other in times of trouble, have allowed us to be the best that we could ever be in these times. As we look ahead at this time of spring, of rebirth, as we celebrate the festival of Pesach, the significance of the sense of freedom that we get, thank you for being our light in what was at times incredibly dark and challenging times. Thank you for continuing to hold us to high standards. And thank you for being so present and so trusting, so incredibly supportive. I wish you all a wonderful, peaceful spring festival, whether it is Pesach or Easter. A happy Easter, if that is what you celebrate. Chag Sameach. A happy Passover, if that is what you are celebrating this week.